There is a new crisis, rather, tonight for Americans still inside Afghanistan. CBS's Charlie Daggett has details from Doha, Qatar.
The demonstrations haven't stopped despite the risks. Women demanding that their rights will be protected under Taliban rule. Eyewitnesses say the Taliban broke up this protest after firing guns into the air. But allegations of Taliban brutality have begun to emerge. Family members say heavily pregnant mother Banu Nagar was shot dead in front of her children in Ghor, west of Kabul. Graphic pictures appear to show her badly disfigured face. The Taliban denies any involvement and say they're investigating. The militants have also been accused of holding Americans hostage, a senior congressional source told CBS News. Satellite images show six chartered aircraft at the airport at Mazar-e-Sharif in northern Afghanistan, which are reportedly being grounded by the Taliban, meant for evacuating a number of U.S. citizens and Afghan interpreters destined for Doha. As the Taliban tightens his grip across the country, fighting has been raging in the Panjshir Valley north of Kabul. The leader of the resistance, Ahmed Massoud, said he's now ready for talks with the Taliban. In Kabul, they're whitewashing the blast walls. They say getting it clean and ready for the new government. And scenes few would have imagined under Taliban rule, a full house stadium to watch a cricket match. Taliban and Afghan flags waving side by side. A moment of respite while Afghans wait to learn what the new government has in store.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is due to arrive here in Doha in the coming days. This country has been vital in the evacuation of U.S. citizens and Afghans by the tens of thousands to the U.S. airbase here. Jerika?
Charlie Daggett, thank you.